relational operator. So relational operator means that we relate two values together. Assume that we have number 3 and 5, two numbers. So they are called operands. Remember? Operands. Okay, operands. So these are called what? Operations or operators? Operation or operator? Operator. Operator. These are operator and these are? Yes. Operation. Okay. Now, the relational operators, we are using the relational operators to relate two things with each other. Two things. So they are binary operators. Remember? Binary operators. Okay. So, for example, plus is a binary operator because it takes two numbers to add up. Right? So, these relational operators are binary operators. So, they relate two operands each other. For example, less than operator. Less than operator relates if left side is less than the right side. The result of these operators always either true or false. True or false. In computer, false means always zero in C. What the true means? True is a any number other than zero. So 5 is true, minus 5 is true, minus 5.1 is true, but 0 false. Okay, I think everybody remembers. Now let's clear all these things. So from mathematics, I think everybody knows, but pay attention these two. Now less than or less than and greater than are, we already know. The result is always 1 or 0. Okay. Now, in mathematics, we write this. Left side is less than or equal to the right side. The question is that. The answer is always 1 or 0. Two answers. Okay. But here, this is in mathematics. But in C, we cannot write this in the keyboard. So we are using less and equal sign together as a one operator. Okay. The next one is greater than or equal. So in mathematics, it's like that in mathematics. But in C, it must be two symbols, one and the second symbol. So in the exams, when you write something by your handwriting, don't use this. Please use this one. Last 15 weeks, we already discussed what is the difference between this symbol and this symbol. This symbol is for assignment operator. This symbol is for equal operator. In mathematics, remember, there is only one operator for both of the operations. Don't confuse, okay? In C, this is for assignment and this is for if they are equal or not, relational operator. And this is very similar that the reverse of the equal is not. So this operator is not, meaning not, exclamation mark, not equal. So it means that left side is not equal to the right side. The result always one or zero, true or false. So do you have any questions? So these are binary operators because they takes only two operands. So I will continue. No questions. Okay, let's do one simple example. Now, in C, the if is a keyword. Remember keyword? Keyword. So it is a reserved word as well, the same idea. So you cannot use if as a variable name, function name, blah, blah. If is reserved for the C compiler. After the keyword, we have the parentheses. Okay. Remember why we use the parentheses as a parameter list or giving the priority, right? Here we are using the parentheses for providing the condition. Condition to the if statement. The condition must be, most of the time, an expression. A condition is an expression. So what we do the expression, what we are going to do the expression, we are evaluating the expression to find the result. In our case, the condition result must be either true or false. Okay, do you understand? So we are given a condition. We need, this is an expression. We need to evaluate this condition. We need to find the result. One or zero. One means true. Zero means false. Five means true. Zero means false. Minus five means true. Zero means false. Now, after the condition, we put these curly brackets. Do you remember the curly brackets? These are called code blocks. Remember? Code block. And we discuss as a, remember? Toast. Remember? Toast. What does it mean? All or none. All or none. Okay. So, if the condition is true, if the condition is true, let's say condition is true, we are gonna execute the first statement after the condition. The rule is that if the condition is true, we are gonna run the first statement after the condition. Now, where is the first statement after the condition? Or what kind of a statement is that? It is a compound statement. Compound. So, what is a compound statement? Let me put here. There are two kinds of statements. What is a statement? Statement is any instruction ending with a semicolon. So, what is a statement? Statement is any instruction ending with a semicolon. Okay, yes, semicolon. So there are two kinds of statements. One is simple statement, right? Simple statement. Yes, Duygu knows. Yes, simple. Başak knows. Yes, you are correct. Simple statements. For example, this is a simple statement alone. What is a compound statement? So compound statements means that we are using a curly bracket and put inside many statements. This is, for example, beginning from here, ending from here. This is a, if there are one or many statements, all of them is a single compound statement. Now, do you understand that simple statement, compound statement, simple statement, only one statement, compound statement, maybe between the compound statement, there will be many statements, or there will be only one statement in between, but still it is a compound statement. Okay? Now, let's clear all this. Now, let's talk about this. This is the keyword if. This is the condition. Okay? Condition. Now, if the condition is true, we are gonna execute the first statement after the condition. If the condition is false, we are gonna execute the something I am going to discuss. But for the moment, let me explain simple way. Okay, simple ways. Now, if the condition is false and if there is a else part, then we are gonna do the first statement after the else part. Any questions? So if the condition is true, We are gonna do the first statement after the condition when it's true. But if the condition is false and if there is else part, we are gonna do the first statement. Let's put if the condition is false, we are gonna do the first statement after the else part. Is that clear? Okay. Now I will give you a naming for this. Let's say that the first statement after the condition is called part A. Yes. Let's say that the first statement after the else is part B. Okay. But pay attention that it is only the first statement. Only the first statement. So what is the part A? Part A is first statement after the condition. Where is the part B? Part B is the first statement after the else. But please pay attention. Only the first statement, not the second statement, not the first statement. Now, do you understand part A and part B? Do you understand part A and part B? Part A is the first statement after the condition. Condition is finishing after the parenthesis. Condition is finishing. The first statement after the condition is the part A. Where is part B? The first statement after the else. Okay. It is simple, but we are gonna use. But please pay attention. Only the first statement, not the second, not the third. Okay. But only the first statement. Okay, I will clear all this. Now, if condition is true, do part A. If condition is false, do part B. Do you understand this? After, so in the condition could be either true or false. So there will be no third option. Is there a third option? No. Only true or false. So look at this. If the condition is true, we are gonna do either the part A. If the condition is false, we are gonna do the part B. Is that clear? So either true or false. How can we find if it is true or false? We need to evaluate the expression in the condition. Okay. Any questions? No. So I will move on. Okay. But don't forget, always first statement. Now let's do some simple thing. Do you think that here after the condition in part A, how many statements? Write to the chat screen. In part A, how many statements we have after the condition? Condition finish here. After the condition, how many statements between else and condition? So condition is finish here. Else is here. Between the condition and else, how many statements here? Please write. Atakan writes A and B, there is two. Between the condition and the before the else, how many statements here? Osman, part A2, two, no. One compound statement. Yes, Duygu knows. There is only one statement in between, which is a compound statement. In the compound statement, how many simple statements? Two. Yes, but forget this. Now the question is that after the condition, before the else, how many statements? Only one statement. Which kind of a statement? It is a compound. Remember, statement says a statement can be simple or compound. Now this is compound because we have the curly brackets. Everybody understands? Okay. I repeat. After the condition, before the else, how many statements we have here? How many? Only one. What kind of that statement? Compound. Not simple. It's not simple. It is compound. Osman, it's not simple. Okay, let's ask the part B. This is part A. Okay, part A. So part A is a compound statement and only one. Let's talk about the part B. Where is part B? Part B is the first, don't forget, the first statement after the else. Now, after the else, what kind of a statement, the first statement after the else, what kind of a statement is that? Simple or compound after the else? No, it's not simple, Ali. It's compound, look. It's compound. Compound means that beginning with a curly bracket, ending with a curly bracket. So it's a compound. In the compound statements, there is a simple statement, but itself, this one is compound statement. Everybody remember sandwich? Sandwich is a compound statement. Okay, let's do again. This is the part A. And part A is a one statement, but it is a compound statement. Look at, this is the part B. Part B is a one statement because it's a compound statement. Is that right? Do you want me to make a magic? Do you want me to make a magic? Let's do a magic. Let's do a very quick magic for you. Okay. Now, tell me, where is part A? Where is part A? Okay, the second question. How many statements between condition and else? How many statements between the condition and else? How many statements? Only two guys replied. What about the others? Three? Are you sure? Yes, there are only two. Look, the first statement, the second statement between the condition and else. And what kind of these statements? They are all simple, right? So where is part A? Part A is always the, remember, first statement. So part A is only that one. Do you agree? Everybody agrees? Okay. Now, what about the second part? The second statement. Do you think that this statement belongs to part A or not? No. Because the definition of part A is, remember, the first statement after the condition. Not the second statement. Not the second statement is the part A. Everybody remembers? The question is that, do you think that two simple statements equals to one compound statement? Is that like that? No. Compound statements means that you have to use these symbols, the curly brackets. Is there any curly brackets here? Is there any curly brackets here? No. No. Okay, I clear everything again. Now, I will do better using the Zoom better. Now, kimde o soruyu soran? Osman, look at to the screen. Tell me, How many statements between from here to here? How many statements here? Osman. Two. Right? Yes, of course, I remove it. What you are seeing on the screen is the question. Do you remember from the class? Magic means that I am removing something. Whatever see on the screen is the question. There is no curly brackets. Duygu, do you understand? Now, what kind of these statements? What kind of these two statements? Simple. Because there is only one and there is only one. Is there any curly bracket here? Do you see any curly bracket here? No. So this is the first statement. This is the second statement after the condition. Is that right? Yes. Then, where is part A? Part A. Where is part A? Remember? Only the first statement after the condition. Remember? Now, this is the part A. Everybody agrees. Do you agree that this is the part A? Because part A is the first statement after the condition. Everybody agrees? Any confusion? So I can continue? Any confusion? Okay. This is the second statement. This is the second statement after the condition. But there is no else between. So do you think that this is part B? Do you think that this is part B? This statement is part B. Yes, no. Yes or no question. Is it part B? No. Because what is the part B definition? Part B definition. Part B definition is that after the else, remember, first statement, only first. Is it after the else? This statement is after the else? No. So it cannot be part B. Okay, so this is the magic. So this is the part A, this is the one. Next week, we are gonna talk about dangling as. Next week, dangling as, we are gonna talk. So we are gonna go into details, but for the moment, it's enough to understand what I am talking. So part A now, after the first statement, after the condition, which is a compound statement. Part B is the first statement after the else part, and now it is a compound statement. Is that clear? Everybody understands the simple idea? So this is part A, this is part B, both of them is a compound statement. Finish. Anybody problem? Okay, I have to move on because we are a little bit slow for the moment. Okay, now let's see the president's rule. It's very important. So we always remember, right? The parenthesis is the king. Assignment is the last one. Huh? We already know that from arithmetics, these are the guys. And now we are, today we learn these two. So these are the relational operators. The less than or equal, greater than equal comes before the if equal or not equal. Okay? So you have to memorize. I continue. Don't forget to memorize all these, okay? Now there are some examples. Assuming that these are the initial values. So this statement is variable declaration with initialization, right? These are the initial values A, B, C. Now let's solve one example. Okay, let's solve this example. C is less than or equal to A. What will be the value? What's gonna be the value of that expression? Result of that. Let's say result of that expression. Write to the screen. I mean chat screen. Zero. One guy said zero. Zero. Another idea, zero, always zero. Yes, it's gonna be zero because C value is 3, A value is 1, C is less than or equal to A, no, the result will be zero. For that one, what's gonna be the value? A not equal to B. What's gonna be? Yes, everybody knows it is 1. Bravo. Do it at home, okay? At home. Do it at home. So, I will continue. Okay. Now, it's very important to understand that in the condition, remember the conditions in between the parentheses, there is the condition. And each condition is a, remember that, what is each condition? Remember, each condition is a expression. This expression can be arithmetic expression. Arithmetic expression means that we can use the arithmetic operators inside the expression. You know that in the arithmetic expressions, we can find the result as a number. For example, 78 minus 78 as a result. So how can we convert this result to, remember that the condition either true or false. You might remember the numeric value is zero, then it means false. But other than zero, all the numbers means true. Okay. So if you see a number other than zero in the condition, it means true for the if statement. Do you understand this? Other than zero. It's simple, but keep in mind. Let's continue. Let's do some simple example. Which one? Let's do this. This is the arithmetic expression. These are the declaration, a variable declaration with initialization. So, C value, what is the C value is? Integer 3. What's the B value? 2. What's A value is? 1. Now, C minus 1. How many operators here in that expression? How many operators? Yes, 2 operators. Which one I have to begin with? From the left one, from the right one? From the left one, from the right one? Left, right. Nobody decided. Left, right. Anybody remembers? Left, right. Look, left to right. Look here. Left to right. Okay, please, you have to memorize all these, not random results. Left to right. Okay. Okay, let's continue with the example. Where are we? Now, what is the result for that example? It's very simple, I believe. What's the numeric value? C is 3, 3. Let's put 3 minus 2 minus 1. Numeric value is 0. True, false value for the if condition, it is true. Right? It's true. No, it's gonna be false. Remember, zero means false. Okay, not one. Somebody write one. No, it's not one. Zero is zero. If the value is zero, it means false. Okay, let's clear all this. Any questions? The rest you have to do at home. Okay. Now, you might remember from our previous classes, we have flow control. Remember flow chart? We talk about in the flow chart. We have the control of flow. So we have the flow. Flow means that you remember CPU. In CPU, we have the instructions to do this, do this, do this. So CPU have to understand which next instruction it should do. So the flow means that we are providing the sequence of the instructions. Do this, do this, do this, next, next, next. Okay. In the, there are three flow of code, three kinds. The first one is sequence. Sequence means that you are writing the code, one statement, next statement, three statements. So this is the sequence. So you are doing from top to bottom. So this is simple sequence. Everybody knows this. Okay. For the other one, flow control, I mean, this is the second flow control, the selection statement. So in the flow chart, remember the diamond, true or false. Remember, we put true, false. Huh? So this is the decision point, remember. So in the C, for the decision point, we have the if condition. So if the condition true, we will go to part A. If the condition is false, if there is the else part, we are gonna part B. Okay. That's the idea in selection. In the repetition, we are gonna see 2 weeks later. In the repetition, remember that we have a loop in the flow chart. We are doing the same statements after and after and after until the condition is false. When the condition false, we continue with the out of the loop, remember? So we are gonna see this part 2 weeks later. Today, we are learning this selection part. Okay, let's continue. Now, what time? Are we good in time? Yes, we have the 20 minutes. Okay, so I will finish on time, I believe. So let's remember again, if is the keyword, and parenthesis is for providing the condition. Condition is a expression. Expression, any statement with operators, variables, constants, numbers, functions. So we need to evaluate the expression, find the result. If result is zero, it means false. If result is one, it means, or not one only, but any number, minus 1.5, any numbers other than zero, it means true, okay? So if the condition is true, we are gonna do the part A. So where is part A? The first statement after the condition. So what kind of statements we have? We have two kinds of statements. One is simple, the other is
compound.
Yes, the compound statement is the curly brackets, beginning and ending. Everything in between this is a compound statement. Even there is one single simple statement, but if there is this curly bracket beginning and ending, this block, code block, is a compound statement. So that's the what we learned so far. Okay. Now, so we are gonna do the part A, the first statement after the condition. Okay, let's continue. Any questions? Okay. Now see some simple examples. Somebody unmute himself or herself, please put to mute. Okay. So everybody can hear me better. Let's do some simple example. Let's put here, for example, integer A is zero. For that code, what's gonna be the output on the screen? Let's say it's the screen. What we are gonna see on the screen? Let's do. So A initial value is zero. We have the if statement, so we have the condition. Do you think that condition is true or false? True or false? The condition is zero is not greater than 8, then the condition is false. If the condition is false, what should I do? If there is an else part, I have to go to the else part. Is there any else part? Is there no? If there is no else part, I have to continue with after the part A. So let me put here, if there is no else, What should I do if the condition is false and if there is no else? I have to continue with the first statement after part A. Okay, let me put here printf. Okay, part C. What I am going to see on the screen now? Since the condition is false, since there is no else here, I have to continue with the first statement after the part A. Where is part A begins? Part A begins after the condition. Where is part A finish? With that curly bracket. After the part A finishing here, I have to continue the first statement. On the screen, I am going to see part C. Any questions for that example? Any questions? Do you understand what I am doing? Everybody? Should I repeat? Do you want me repeat? Yes or no? Do you want me repeat? Okay, Nasra asked me to repeat. Okay, I will clear and repeat. Now, in the if statement, we have the if, we have a condition, we have the, let's say, part A, then we can have else, then we have the part B, and let's say that we have the part C. Okay, now, if the condition is true, let me put some other color. Yes. If the condition is true, we are gonna do part A. Then we have to continue with part C. Okay. So we will move like that. If the condition is true, we are gonna do part A. Then we are gonna continue part B. Can I do part B? No, because if the condition is let me change the color. If the condition is false, I have to continue with part B, then I have to continue with the part C. Part C means that rest of the program, rest of the code. Okay, rest of the code. All right. Now, this is understandable because let's check again. Okay, this is very easy to understand because in this structure we have the if keyword, we have the else keyword, right? Okay. Now, if the condition is true, we have to do part A. If condition is false, we have to do part B. But in any case, we have to continue with the part C. Do you understand this? Because it is the rest of the code. We have to continue the code is not finishing here. Part B or part A, we don't stop here. We have to continue with the part C to the rest of the program. Everybody understands? Yes or no? Everybody understands? No? Okay, I will explain again. We are writing 10,000 satures, 10,000 lines of code. Assume that we are writing 10,000 of lines of code. 10,000. There are many. Right. Here, there is only some part of is if, else. Then, if the condition is true, you are doing this point, else, this point. Then, after that, what you have to do? After that, you have to continue the code. So, if the condition is true, you are going to do the part A. And then part C. If the condition is false, then you do the first part B, then part C. Do you understand? Yücel, do you understand? Okay, can I continue? Okay, so basically means that, okay, you have to understand this, that it's simple. If the true condition is true, we are gonna do part A. If the condition is false, we are gonna do part B. But in both case, we have to continue with the part C. the rest of the code. Okay. But we are only selecting, deciding if we are doing the part A or part B. One of them. Depending on the result of the condition. If condition is true, I will do this. If the condition is false, I will do this. But, okay. I will show something else. Where is the... Okay, share whiteboard. Now, everybody sees the whiteboard? Okay, in the whiteboard, I will put you some two things. Okay. Now, in one structure, we have if condition and let me say part A, okay, and part C. In the second version, let's say call this version one, okay. Let's say this is the version two. If condition, okay, here is part A. Else, now, part B. And here, part C, rest of the code. Okay, do you understand? So what I am trying to say that, okay, this condition is the same for the both versions. These are the same condition. Okay, no problem. But here we have the else part. So in the else part, it means that if the condition false, we have a special thing to do. But look at the left side. Is there any else part? We don't have any else part. We only have a part C. You see? We have also a part C. Okay, now you can follow with me if I think it will be very easy for you now. Let's say that if the condition is true, if the condition is true, what happens? So if the condition is true, we are gonna do the part A. After part A, finishing part A, we are gonna continue with the part C. Any problem with that? Okay. Now, for the version 2, if the condition is true, we are gonna do part A. After doing part A, I cannot continue with part B because it's not true. Then I have to continue with part C. Is that understandable for everyone? Is it simple? Okay. Now, let's say that the condition is false. Okay. Ömer, why you are so late? Ömer, why are you so late? Please write to the chat screen. And now, if it is false, can I do part A? Can I do part A? Yes or no question. No, I cannot do part A. Is there an else part to go to part B? No. What should I do? I have to continue with part C. Do you have any questions? Do you have any questions? Okay. Let's see for the second version. Assume that the condition is false. Can I do part A? No. Is there any else part? Yes. What should I do? I have to go to the part B. After then, finishing part B, what should I do? Can I go to part A? No. I have to jump to the part C. Remember, part C means that rest of the code. Okay, any questions? Do you have any question? I am looking to the chat screen. Do you have any question? No? Is it understandable both this? Okay, I will save this. Okay. If you don't have questions, I will jump back to the slide. Any questions? Okay, I am jumping. New slides, where we are. the screen. Okay. Now. So in that example, if you look at this example, please annotate. Okay. Now look at this example. Look at this example. Okay. And assume that there is a one statement here. Print f part c. So what is the output? So if integer, remember, age is zero. Okay. So zero is not greater than this. So the condition is false. And we know that the first statement after the condition is part A. I cannot do part A. Is there any else part? No. So the first statement after the part A is part C. This is the part C. So if the condition is false and if there is no else part, I continue with the part C. On the screen, I am going to see part C. Okay. So you are gonna see part C. I am solving this example, not this example. Okay. I am solving this example, not this example, this example. Let's solve the next example. Okay. So I am going to solve. This example. Now I am going to solve this example. Okay. Pay attention to this example. Let's add here. Print f part c. Okay. Let's add integer value. Oh, I'm sorry, value. Zero. Okay. What's the output for that code? What's the output? What's the output? What's the output? So value zero equals to zero, then the result is, tell me, the result is true. If the result is true, I have to go to the part A. Where is part A? The first statement after the condition. What kind of a statement part A is? It is a compound statement. So this is a part A. In the part A, how many simple statements we have? Two simple statements in the part A. Do this. After part A, where should I continue with? After part A, I have to continue with part C. Where is part C? The first statement after the part A, because there is no part B. Where is the first statement after the part B? After the curly bracket of part A. Now, print sequence. So we are gonna see these three statements. The value you enter was zero. Please try again and PC. Okay, everybody follows me? Any questions? Can I continue?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so I will continue, clear all this. Let's continue. Now, there is the else one. Let's solve this example if you like, okay. But before solving this example, I would like to add here, printf, that's part. C. Now, assume that this is the thing. Okay. Now, let's do together once more and finalize. If the condition is true, what we are gonna do? Okay. But before beginning this, where is part A? Let's locate it. Where is part A? The part A is always after the first statement after the condition. This is the condition ends. This is the first statement begins. So this code block is, tell me, part A. Where is part B? You have to look if there is any else or not. Yes, there is any else. Yes. Where is part B? The first statement after the else. The first statement after the else. So this is part B. Where is part C? Since there is the else part, the first statement after the part B is the part C begins and continue like that. Do you understand part A, B, and C on that example? Do you understand? Yes. Okay. Now, let's continue if it is true what we are gonna do. If it is true, we are gonna do part A, then part continue with part C. Let me repeat. If the condition is true, do part A, then continue with part C. Let's do. If the condition is true, do part A, then continue with part C. Do you understand? Any questions? No. If the condition is false, what I am going to do? If there is else, here we have the else, then part B, then continue with part C. So if the condition is false, jump to the part B, then continue with part C. Because this is the version 2 if, right? This is the version 2 if. If else. Any questions? Do you have any question? Nope. Okay. So I am clearing and continue. No questions. No questions. Okay. Now, let's do this example again. But now it's changed a little bit. Integer h is 0. And let's put here printf. Okay. What I'm going to write? Part C. Now, and semicolon. What is the output of that code? What's the output? Bilge, I am almost finishing it, so I cannot give a break. I asked the break, and most of the guys said no. Okay. I have only 5 minutes to finish. Okay. I have to finish. Okay. So what's gonna be the output? So the condition is true or false? Tell me. The condition is false. So I have to, is there any else part? Yes. So I have to continue with the part B. On the screen I am going to see maybe next time. After part B, I have to continue with part C. So I will see the here, maybe blah 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 and part C. But assume that it is 20 right now, then it's gonna be true. The condition gonna be true. If it's true, I will do part A and then C. Then if it's true, the part A is here. So on the screen, I am going to see what. Then I am going to see part C. Okay. Okay. So I think everybody follows me. So we already talked this. Okay, do it all. Now, for this, what is the output? What is the output? Now I will send you a poll. You just click the poll, okay? I will try to, yes, launch the poll. So what is the output? Can you see the polls? Can you see the poll? So what's the output? The output A is 1. A is 2, A is 3, logical error, syntax error, nothing, I have no idea. So click the poll. Nobody has replied so far. Nobody replied. Can you see the poll or no? Allah Allah, neden? Dur bakalım. New share. Let's stop the share. Pause share. And polling. Relaunch poll. Yes. Now do you see the poll? So what is gonna be the output? What's gonna be the output? There could be more than one correct answer, okay? Okay, only 10 students reply. Okay. You can select, I have no idea, okay? You can select, I have no idea, no problem. Just select something, okay? All right. So I am finishing the poll. Okay. Now, let's end poll. Share results. Do you see the result? So most of the guys say A is 2. Okay, everybody sees the result? I think you see the result. Now stop share the result. Yes. Okay. Now continue. Now let's see actually. Now A is 2, no problem with that. Now, do you think that, what about this condition? Do you think that, what does it mean? It means that A equals to 1 or 1 is assigned to A. Which one? It's not equal. It's not a relational operator. There is a mistake here. So this mistake, because of this mistake, something happens. Look at here. Now, A value at the beginning is 2. After that, now A is 1. All right, 1. But remember that in between the curly bracket, now we have assuming 1. So 1 means true or false. There is no syntax error. Remember that a numeric number should, it means true. Since this is true, you have to do the part A. Where is part A? The first statement after the condition. After the condition. So you are gonna see on the screen A is 1. Now. And continue with part C. Now this is the part C. Do you think that A equals to 2? No, because A is 1. So is there else part? No, I have to continue with the part C of that. Now this part C, A is not checked with 3 equal or not, but A is assigned to 3. Now is the value is here 3. Is that 3 true? Yes. So on the screen I am going to see these and these. There is no syntax error. There is no syntax error, but there is a logical error, because on the screen we are gonna see this. A is 1, A is 3. Actually A is 2. A was 2. So there is a logic error. How can we fix this error? How can we fix this error? Simply by writing double equal sign here and here. Now what's gonna be the result? A is 2. It's false, continue with part C. A is 2, it's correct, continue with part A on the screen. Then continue with the part C, and it's not correct, then finish. Everybody follows? Yeah? Okay. So let's do one more example here. Now, what's the result? Look at carefully. What's the result? I will try to put the polling again. So you can select the poll. What's the result? A is 2, then blah, 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 blah. Yes. What you would see on the screen, you can select multiple. Multiple choices. You can select. Multiple answers are correct. So you can click I have no idea as well. No problem. Okay. I will stop the polling if you finish. Okay. So the most of the results are logical error. And A is 1, A is 2, A is 3. Let's see together. Now, let's continue. So A is 2. Now is A is becomes A was 2, but now it becomes 1. And here is 1. 1 means true. On the screen we are gonna see this. After then I cannot continue with part B. You see that there is the part B. So I cannot continue with part B. And part B is going like that. You see? This is the whole part B. And finish the program because part C is here. So on the screen I am going to see is only is A is 1. Okay? So on the screen we are only see A is 1. Okay? I continue with the next example. So tell me what's the result. Okay. Again, another poll. What's the result? Be careful. A is 2, then blah, 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 blah. Be, pay attention, part B and part C. Part B and part C. You can click, I have no idea if you don't have. So, okay, I am waiting for your answers. Yes, most of the guys already answer. Okay, good, very good. Now, let's see this. So, most of the guys say A is 1 on the screen. Let's check together. All right, now. Okay, now, A is 2. Now A is 1, so I begin with 2, but assign 1, but inside 1, so 1 means it is true. True means if it's true, remember, part A. Is there any part B in here or not? So this is if, there is else, so else means that there is a part B. Where is part B of that statement? Where is part B? Part B, how can we define the first statement after the else? The first statement after us begins here. But where it finishes? Where it finishes? The important questions are. We begin from here. Okay, this is another if. This if finishes here. Is that right? Yes. So this yellow region is the part B of the first if. This if. So since it is true, huh? Since it is true, we are gonna do part A then part C. Where is part C? Part C, remember, is the first statement after the part B. So now I will put A is on 1 on the screen. Now I will jump to here because after A, I have to go to the part C, not part B. Now A is 3, so now it's gonna be 3. On the screen, I am going to see this. Okay, so let's see the result here. So A is 1, A is 3, 3. Ah, don't forget there is 3 number as well. Why? Because of the placeholder and A here. Okay. Now there is a question that you see that this if has an else part. In the else part, the statement is the if statement. So this if statement is the part B of that if. Okay. But this if statement is the version 1 if. Remember, there is version 1 if and version 2 if. The first statement I will show you right now. Okay. I will clear everything now. The first statement begins from here and ends here. Okay. This is one if. What kind of if this? This is version 2 if, because it has the if, it has the else. Inside the else part, we have another if. What kind of if this? Version 1. In the part C of that if, there is another if here. This if is version 1 if there is no else. So what you see is that nested if. Nested if. One if is inside in the other if. This if is inside the else part of that if. Okay? Yücelen, do you understand? Okay. So these are the, I am checking if there is another examples. Okay, these are the questions for you. Okay. So please do at home these questions. Okay. Please do it at home these questions. Do it home. If you don't have any questions, I will finish the class right now.